Well, today is a topic that I think we can all relate to. We're going into related rates. And of course, even the word is pretty descriptive about what's happening, because we hear the word rates and we think derivatives. And we hear the word related and we say, oh, derivatives that are somehow connected together. And that's actually the whole idea. But of course, we should talk about the details. So let's get into it. So the idea is we have some relationship between our variables. And so our variables can be any name you want. We oftentimes use X and Y for variables, but keep in mind, we can just choose whichever convenient names are available to us. And so there's some relationship. So for example, here's just one I made up. X cubed plus XY plus Y to the fifth equals 7. We said, okay, now these variables are related to each other. Now at this second, if you just saw that, you'd say, hey, wait a second, we've seen something like this before. When we talked about implicit differentiation, we had that sort of mind bubble, like, what do we do? Well, we think of, say, y as being a function of x. But we're not doing implicit differentiation, we're switching. So here's our new thought. So our new is to say, hey, what we have is we have these two variables which are connected together, but there's a hidden parameter. Now, we often use t, and I think a good way to think of our hidden parameter is time. So there's this hidden parameter called t. And what's happening is that x and y change with respect to t. But it's not that x and y are independent from each other. It's really we think of x as changing and y as changing, but there's a relationship between how they change. And so the relationship that connects the variables should somehow give a relationship to how the changes of these variables are connected, or in other words, how the derivatives are connected. So that's what we want to do. So what's our idea? Well, now we say, let's take the derivative of everything with respect to t. And of course, that means even more chain rule. So you know, we think of x as a function of t and y as a function of t. And now we just see what relationship pops out between their derivatives. Now, one of the things that makes this a fun topic is we're really starting to transition into more of the applications. And in particular, we're going to see a lot of word problems. So we get to do our practice of saying, oh, let's take this long block of text and figure out what it's asking. So we're going to practice translating back and forth between math and some sort of English in this particular case. So it's that learning to translate. How do we extract formulas from writing? Well, once we can figure that out, we're going to be in pretty good shape. We're going to be able to do all sorts of fun problems. All right, so let's talk about the particular process. It's a very short process, indeed. The first step is the hardest step. In fact, I would say that probably step one is 80% of the work. And that is, we have to find the relationship. In a handful of cases, they'll just give it to us, but don't anticipate that. So we have to figure out what the relationship is. So here's some advice. When possible, draw a picture. This is just general advice for problems. When you want to understand what's happening, draw a picture. And when you draw a picture, there's some advice down here which says, label everything. You know, in particular, what you want to do, when we say label everything, you should label everything which varies. So you want to figure out, what are the things which are changing? Anything which can change. And anything you think of, anything that's moving with time, you say, okay, that's a variable. So even the name, you can hear it. Anything which can vary is a variable. So it needs to be assigned a label. And anything which doesn't vary, well, that's a constant, and we just assign whatever value it is. When you work with prompts, you also sometimes throw in coordinate systems. Choose good coordinates. This will come into play more and more, especially as we get into topics like calculus 3, which is a lot about coordinates and understanding how things get set up. But if you need to pick a coordinate system, choose good coordinates. In other words, put your zero in a convenient spot and don't just put it arbitrarily. Now, what are things you should be looking out for? Well, you should be looking out for Pythagorean theorem. So what is that? Well, if you have a right triangle, and which is to say as compared to a wrong triangle. So if your side lengths are A, B, and C, where C is the hypotenuse along the side, then Pythagorean theorem says A squared plus B squared equals C squared. A lot of problems have a right triangle built into it. So for example, sometimes you have things that are against a wall. Well, a wall, you have a wall, and you have the floor, and then you have a convenient right angle. And like, okay, well, that's an example of where you might see a right triangle, and then it shows up in other places as well. So the Pythagorean theorem is a very popular example of a relationship. Another thing you might see is what are called similar triangles. Now, let's recall what similar triangles are. Now, similar means, it almost sounds like the word same. And in some sense, they are the same up to scaling size. So what you might see is something like this, where you have a relationship where, let's say, it doesn't have to be a right triangle, by the way, but you have these two triangles, this smaller triangle inside of this larger triangle. And what happens is that they are the same in terms of their angles, which means that I can scale the small triangle to get the large triangle. Well, how does that come into play? Well, the way it comes into play is you can start labeling things. So suppose we label this, for instance, I'll call this A, and we'll label this B, and let's call this little distance here X, and we'll call this distance here Y. Now, I'm not saying that these are good choices. Indeed, you want to look at the problem, and the problem will tell you what you should be labeling. So what you have in similar triangles, what makes them so nice, is that the ratios of sides are equal. What that means is if I take the ratio of this length to that length in the small triangle, so A to B. So A to B, that's a ratio, is the same as the same set of sides in the same ratio for the large triangle. So that would be the whole length here, which would be A plus X, see that's the length of the whole side, and then that length is Y. And now, there I go. Now I have a relationship that I can work with. And hopefully I know a couple of different things. Of course, we don't necessarily jump right into taking derivatives. We want to make sure we clean things up, make things work very well. The other thing you might see showing up are things like geometry. So you might see circles, you might see squares, cubes, cones, spheres. So if you have problems which involve geometrical shapes, think about, okay, what are the formulas that describe things? Like what's the volume of a sphere? What's the surface area of a sphere? Things like that. We're going to see a lot of this. In fact, we have a lot of practice today. Because there's so many things we can do. So we're going to get a lot of practice in setting up problems and solving these problems. But okay, we found a relationship. We've successfully completed step one. Well, step two is now says, all right, once you have your relationship, take the derivative. Take the derivative of everything with respect to that parameter. Again, best to think of as time. And this is where it's important to say, what's a constant? So in other words, what's fixed and doesn't change, and what's a variable? Anything which is a variable has a derivative. So you got to keep track of those things. And the last thing is, well, now, plug in everything that you know. Because oftentimes you'll say, well, I know what the value of this variable is, I know what this rate is, I know what this variable is. In fact, I know everything except one piece of information. You're like, perfect! Now, let's figure out what that one piece of information is. And so we can solve for what we want. So that's it. Find your relationship. Take the root of everything with respect to your parameter. Plug in what you know. Solve for what you don't. Good. Well, that's our idea. Pretty straightforward, but of course, as they say, the devil's in the details, because there's a lot of things that can happen, which means we need to practice. This is a great time to do practice. So let's get going.